Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at translating text and entire web pages. So say you're visiting some web pages and they're in a different language. Let's say you're an English speaker like myself and you're visiting a site here that's in French or maybe one that's in Spanish. You can do several different things to translate the text there so you can understand the page. First thing you want to look for is a lot of pages will have their own translations. You want to look around on the web page for something that allows you to switch the language. So in this case you can see here the select country, and sure enough if I move my cursor over it I can see that there are a variety of different languages here and I can choose one. So I can choose English. Sometimes it's done with little flags. You see little flags here like French and English, and I could switch over to the English version of this page. When you're looking for flags, if you're an American, sometimes look for the British flag because that represents English. And sometimes there's an American flag for American English and a British flag for British English, and maybe even several other flags. Sometimes it's in the upper right hand corner, sometimes it's at the bottom of the page. Look around to see if you could find that. As a matter of fact, many web pages will recognize where you're located and take a best guess at the language. When I went to both of these sites, they guessed that my location was in the United States and showed me the English version of the page. I had to switch over to the Spanish and French versions. But let's say you're at a website and it doesn't have that option. It's only in a language that you don't speak. Well, you can translate the entire web page using several different sites, but I'm going to show you Google Translate. So if you go to translate.google.com, it takes you to the Google Translate site, and you can put text in here. You can copy and paste text in here, or you can paste a URL. So let's go and take this URL here, go over to Google Translate, paste it in here, and you can see that it's actually going to put a link there. I click on the link and I'm still in Google Translate. You can see the stuff here at the top, but you could see now it has translated this from Spanish to English. It actually automatically recognizes that it's in Spanish. That's not always perfect. Sometimes I've been at sites where they've been in Italian and it thinks it's Spanish, or they've been in Japanese and it thinks it's Chinese. It's not perfect, so you can always change what it is here. And it's going to translate the entire page, so all the different text on it, as long as it's not in a graphic, it's actually in text, it's going to be translated. And the translation's not perfect. For instance, you can see here this text here, not perfect English. And if I were actually went over to the regular site, switched over to English, I would get a much better translation, which is why it's always important to look for the ability for the website to switch languages, because that's how you get the best translation. Now, if you don't want to translate the entire page, you can translate only a bit of it. So, for instance, we can take that one part and we can select the text. I'm going to copy it, Command C, go over to Google Translate, and Command V, paste it. And you can see there's an example where it didn't get the language right. So I'm going to switch the language right here. There are a ton of different languages available in Google Translate. So I know that this one's in Spanish, so I can tell it I want it to translate Spanish to English, and then it will give me a decent translation. Now, this copy and paste method is also fantastic for email. I get email in non-English languages all the time, either for MacMost or maybe a question about one of my apps. And I like to kind of get an idea of what question I'm being asked. So I'll use Google Translate, copy from the email, paste it in here, and then I can see basically what's there. Now, you can use it the other way as well. I can, for instance, say that I want to go English to Spanish, and I can get a quick translation like that, which can be fun for learning, but you can also make it useful. And the translation is not always going to be perfect, but for a message like this, it doesn't necessarily have to be perfect to get the message across. Now, you have alternatives to using Google. For instance, you can use bing.com/translator, and you can see it works very similarly and has lots of languages as well and could do basically the same kind of thing. Now, if you have the Google Chrome browser, it integrates really well with the Google Translate tool, as you can imagine. And it never hurts to have the Chrome browser in addition to Safari. I prefer Safari, but I have Chrome and I use it for some things. And you can see when I go to this page here, the French version of this page, it actually puts a little thing at the top here telling me the page is in French and would you like to translate it. I can hit Translate, and it's basically the same thing as if I use the Google Translate site and enter the URL. So you can do everything in Safari. You don't need to use Chrome. But if you're going to a lot of different sites that are not in the language that you speak, you may want to use Chrome for quick translation because you get this nice little thing here at the top.